So let us come to here. Just we'll recall what the things we have studied in last class. So we have seen the several different units of length and how we need to convert them from one unit to another unit. We have been discussed in last class. So once again, we'll make the final results. So as we come to know that, what is the SI unit of length? What is the SI unit of length? SI unit of length is
meter,
which we should represent with m. Now this is what our unit. For this, if you are adding prefix of kilo. So kilo means what? Kilo means equals to what? 1000. Correct or not?
Thousand.
So if you make it kilo as a prefix, then it will turns into what? Kilometer. So
kilometer,
which we should represent with what? Km. Km is the unit, and this is a bigger unit of distance or length. This is the bigger unit. So as we know that 1 kilometer equals how many meters? Pranav, Navaneshwaran,
1 kilometer equals 1000 meters.
So from that we have to make another reverse relation. What is the reverse relation, Pranav, Narayan? 1 meter equals 1 by 1000. This is what we have found. Same way next, if you are adding centi, understanding centi for meter, prefix as a centi, then centimeter is the smaller unit of length. So as we know that 1 meter is equal to how many centimeters, Narayan? 100 centimeter. Correct? Pranav? So now from that we can say 1 centimeter is equal to how many meters, Lohit? 1 by 100. Correct or not? Same way we have to say. Next, if you'll add milli, if you'll add milli as the prefix, then it will turns into what? Millimeter. Understand? Millimeter. So which we should represent with a mm, which is represent with a mm. So now, as we know that 1 meter is equal to how many millimeters are Pranav? Navaneshwaran? 1000 millimeters. So from that we know that 1 millimeter is equal to how many meters?
1 by 1000 meters.
Same way, 1 centimeter equals to how many? 1 centimeter equals to how many millimeters? Check your scale and tell me.
10 millimeters.
Very good. So, and from that I can say, speak louder. 1 millimeter equals to how much? 1 by 10 centimeter. In last class, this all the things we have discussed in last class. Even I have given you examples also. Correct or not? Yes or no? Correct? Yes. So now, let us see the remaining things. So we'll continue from today. Understanding. So the next concept which we are going to study is Santosh. Good morning. Have you studied this all? Yesterday we have discussed it. Have you remembered, Santosh? Yes or no? Today we are going to continue. What is our next concept? Measurement of what we should call? Measurement of length. So please all of you keep measurement of length. Measurement of length. Do it. Measurement of length. Correct? So now, all of you on your video also, no problem. On your videos and you do it. Now you can be able to see more clear. So measurement of length. What is this? Let us discuss. What is measurement? Yesterday I have taught you. Suppose if you want to measure, suppose something, we want two things. What is that? Can you able to say? What is that? Please tell me. Measurement means it is a combination of multiple of two things. What is that? Let me know. We have discussed it correct yesterday.
Huh?
Quantity is quantity is equals to. What is the two things?
Unit and magnitude.
Length and unit. So that length, sorry, number and magnitude, number and unit. That number is only known as what? That number is only known as magnitude. That is what we have studied. So let us discuss what is this measurement of length means. So as we know that, what is the meaning of length? What is the meaning of length? Length is the distance between two points. Correct or not? So let us take this is the point one and this is the point two. So the point one and this is the point two. So now if we measure the distance between these two points, that is only known as length. What we should call? L-E-N-G-T-H, length. The distance between any two points, the distance between any two points is known as length. So meter is used as a standard unit for measuring the length of an any object. So what is the standard unit of a length? What is the standard unit?
Meter.
That is what you should remember. The distance between understand, any two points is called length. And the standard unit of length is what, Pranav? Navaneswaran. The standard unit of meter. Which is represented with what? Small n. That is what you have to remember. Next month we have a PT exam. Remember and do it. Understand? So now let us come to here. As you know that this meter is written with a M. So M is the first letter of meter. So that we used to write M. So we can get an idea of the length represented by a meter. Understanding from the fact that suppose, for example, if you take our room door, you can take it. Suppose Naren's home door, room door, you can check it. It will be definitely 1 meter will be. Width will be 1 meter. So means door of our room is about 1 meter wide. Means in the sense of what? We measure the length of an object by using which scale, Ra? Meter scale. Correct or not? So it is 1 meter. 1 meter means how many centimeters? 1 meter means how many centimeters? 1 meter means how many centimeters? 100 centimeters.
100 centimeters.
So a meter scale is, understand, graduated. What is the meaning of graduated, anybody? A meter scale is, if you take the meter scale, for example, this is the scale, just imagine. Understanding, if you take the meter scale, it has been graduated. What is the meaning of graduated, Narayan? Graduated, or we can call it as marked. Remember that, graduated or marked. So marked, 1 meter scale, how many centimeters, Ra? 1 meter scale. 1 meter scale is equal to how many centimeters? 100 centimeters. Correct or not? Yes, that is what you have to remember that. So, move to the next level. What is the next level? What, Naren? This is a. Okay. So, okay, move to the next level. Okay, Naren. So graduated means here scale. Okay, Naren. According to yours also correct it is. But here, the meaning of graduated, the meter scale is graduated means it is marked. Understanding? Marking 100 centimeters and every centimeter is further divided into how many, sir? It is full scale is marking into 100 centimeters. 0, 1, to like that 100 centimeters. So now again each centimeter, how many lines run around? Sanat, everybody. Each centimeter, how many lines? 10 lines. Do you understanding? So each centimeter, 10 lines, and that is only called as 1 centimeter. So each centimeter is marked as in between 10 lines, and totally 1 meter scale is marked as a 100 centimeters. So the centimeters is further divided into 10 divisions. The 10 divisions we used to call as what, Ra? The 10 divisions we used to call as what? What we should call? Each 10 division we used to call as centimeter. Correct or not? Yes or no? So now the 10 divisions, each division is called as what? Each division is called as?
Millimeter.
Do you understand, Ra? So if you take the scale, for example, let us discuss. I will show you the meter scale. So meter scale means how much it is having? How many centimeters it is there? How many
100.
Centimeters? 100 centimeters. Correct or not? So let us discuss now. I will show you the 100. Meter scale. So observe very carefully now and you can tell me what you are observing. So let us discuss this. All of you check this picture. Now how much you are seeing? What is this called as? What is this called as? A meter scale. Correct or not? Naren? Is it yes or no? Yeah, Sanat? Check it. 1 minute. I will change the pen color. Pen color is coming white color. I will change it into some teal color. Oh, okay. Now you can observe here in this picture. This is what it is actually, a meter scale. Correct or not? What is this? The color not changing. Okay. So now if you observe this is called as what? A meter scale. Correct or not? Meter scale. Now, meter scale starting from where? Starting from 0. Correct? And ending from where? Ending from 100. So now you can observe, all of you observe here. So this is 0. 0 to 10 lines if you count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 we are getting what? 1 centimeter. Correct or not? Next, again 10 lines if you count, we are getting what? 2 centimeter. Next 10 lines we are getting what? 3 centimeter. Like that, this meter scale has been separating into 100, 100 equal divisions. So each one is equals to what? 1 centimeter. So from that I can write, 1 meter equals how many centimeters? 1 meter equals to 100 centimeters. From 1 centimeter to another centimeter, let us take anywhere middle. So let me take at 5 to 6. How many lines are there? Count it and tell me. 5 to 6. 5 to 6, how many lines are there? So 10 divisions, 10 equal divisions are present in between the centimeters to centimeter. That is what we can call as millimeters. What we should call? Millimeter. From that I can say each centimeter is equal to how many millimeters? Lohit? Each centimeter is equal to 10 millimeters. So that is what you have to understand. So if you take the meter scale, understand? So 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter and 1 centimeter is equal to 10 millimeter. Is there any doubt in this? Please tell me. Are you clear?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So each small division is representing in this scale, which is equal to how many millimeters? How many millimeters? Each small division is equal to 1 millimeter.
One.
Middle line, little what? Bit bigger is there. Middle little.
Five.
Little bit bigger.
5 millimeter.
This line indicating how much? Narayan, Sanath, Lohit, anybody. The middle little bit big line is there. That point is indicating how much? 0.5, understand, 0.5 it is, remember, means in the sense of 1 millimeter, 2 millimeter, 3 millimeter, 4 millimeter, 5 millimeter, means 5 millimeter, which is equal to how many centimeters? Please tell me, anybody, how many centimeters? Yesterday we have studied, 5 millimeters is
equal to centimeter.
Wrong. 5 millimeters is equal to dash centimeter. So we know that 5 into 1 millimeter we can write it. So 1 millimeter equals how many centimeters, runner? Sanath, Lohit, anybody? 1 by 10 centimeters. Correct or not? So 5 into 1 by 10, understanding, centimeters. So 5 ones are, 5 twos are, which is equal to how much, runner? 1 by 2 centimeter. Understanding? So 1 by 2 means what? 0.5 centimeter. So midline, the line which is little bit thicker, understanding, little bit of length compared to this one, that is indicating always 0.5 centimeter. Understand, Ra? 0.5 centimeter, or I can say 5 millimeter. Do you understand? You understand or not, all of you?
Sir.
That is what. So I said, okay, Narayan, very good. Sir, I also said 1.2. Very good. So this is what you have to remember. Understand?
Sir,
note it down.
Sir, this is what you called as. I cannot understand this.
Meter scale. Understand, Navaneswaran? So.
No, sir.
You can use.
In that, I cannot understand.
Water?
At 5 millimeter, I cannot understand, sir. It's very difficult to understand.
Wait. For example, you see, from 1 centimeter to another centimeter, how many lines are there? 1 centimeter to another centimeter, 10 lines are there. Correct or not?
Yes.
So that is what we are saying. Each line is equals to 1 millimeter. So 10 millimeters is equals to what? Which is equals to, we are saying what? 1 centimeter. Correct?
1 centimeter.
Clear?
Now, sir?
1 centimeter equals how much? Tell me. 1 centimeter equals how much? 1 by 10 millimeter. 1 by 10 millimeter. Correct?
Yes, sir.
Now you see. So 10 lines equals to 10 millimeter means count the middle line, little bit C. Compared to the another lines, this is little bit longer length. That line is called as fifth line. Correct or not?
Yes, sir.
Fifth line means 5 millimeters. Correct or not?
Yes, sir.
5 millimeters is equal to dash centimeters, I am asking. That is what my question. So 5 millimeters, how I can write? Tell me, Navaneswaran. 5 into 1 millimeter, everybody you can speak. Can you write it or not?
Half of a centimeter. Half of a centimeter.
Yeah. 5 into 1 mm. So now in place of 1 mm, what I can write? 1 by 10 mm. Correct or not? Sorry, 1 by 10, yeah, 1 centimeter equals to 1 by 10 mm. So 1 mm equals how much I can write? This is 1 mm. 1 mm equals to 1 by 10 centimeter. So what I can write, which is equals to 5 into 1 by 10 centimeter. Correct or not, Navaneswara?
Yes, sir.
Is equals to 5 by 10 centimeter. So now you do 5 ones are 5 twos are, which is equals to how much? 1 by 2 centimeter. So now check
1
it.
By 2 centimeter.
Do division 2 1 won't go, so we can keep the point and we can keep add 0. So 2 5s are 10, which is equals to 0, which is equals to what? 0.5. correct or not? Understand that? Yes or no,
sir?
So 5 centimeters,
yes, sir.
5 centimeters means what I can say? 0.5, sorry, 5 millimeters equals to 0.5 centimeter. Any doubt in this, ask me please. Do you understand? That's all. So that is what we have to understand. So this scale, this meter scale, we can use, understand, we can measure the length accurately up to how much, Ra? Accurately up to how much we can measure this meter scale. It is having, what is the minimum? What is the minimum length we can measure with this? Sanat, Loket, Narayan, anybody? Santosh?
Millimeter.
1 millimeter. So that is what. So by using this meter scale, we can measure minimum 1 milliliter and maximum how much? Maximum how much? Maximum how much? 100? 1 kilometer. Hundred centimeters means 1 meter, not 1 kilometer. Because it is minimum.
Sir, I have doubt. There is no ruler that has 100 centimeter. Up to 60 only, no, sir.
Hey, who said
in rulers?
Tyler, sir, we used to get 100 meter scale. Okay?
Sir,
30. Our scale only 30. Do you understand, Navaneswara?
Sir?
But meter scale, I'm saying meter scale, understanding, this is a big scale, so you can see in the tailor shops and all. So meter scale, what is the minimum range, Ra? Navaneswara and Lokit, what is happening? Lokit, Sanat, what is the minimum range? 1 millimeter. Correct or not? What's the maximum range?
Yes, sir.
Maximum range, how much? 100 centimeters, or which is equals to what? 1 meter. 1 millimeter is the minimum reading and 1 meter is the maximum reading. So by using this meter scale, we can measure, what is the minimum length, Ra? What is the minimum length we can measure? We can measure
1 millimeter. 1 millimeter.
That is what you have to remember. Using meter scale, please note it down. Using meter scale, we can measure. Sanath, write it. We can measure. Pranav, you also measure. The maximum length is... The maximum length is 100 centimeter or 1 meter, and the minimum length is how much, Sarvesh? How much? 1 millimeter. That is what you have to remember. Maximum 1 meter and minimum 1 millimeter. Please note it down. So this is what we can say. What is measurement of length and why we need to measure and all. Please note it down. Is it clear? Do it. Okay, Pranav. I will share. Is it completed, Narayan? Sanat, Lohit?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, I will share. Don't worry. Do it. Completed? Now, those who want to take the screenshot, you can take the screenshot also. Somebody is asking, Pranav is asking this. This you want, you can take the screenshot also. If you want, we can take the screenshot. That's all. This is what it is. Okay? Then you don't want that? Okay. Yeah. So shall I go to the next concept? Next. So the concept of next one, which we are going to study, is why we need, understand, what is the use of using this units of length? What the use of proper units of length? Please keep it in. The use of So now you tell me, Lohit, Narayan, Sanath, everybody, Santosh, Pranav, what is the use of proper units, Narayan, Sanath, Lohit? What is the, you can speak, why, what is the use of, Santosh?
It will give us a proper measurement.
If you are
measuring a goal, means some piece will miss, yes. Also it will have more value, sir. So only we have proper units.
Yes, though the meter is the standard unit of length, but sometimes other units like centimeters, millimeters, kilometers also be used, depend upon our convenience. Suppose, see, I want to measure very small distance, then I can use millimeters. Little bit longer, centimeters. Little bit longer, meters. Suppose I will say to measure the road from Pudukote to Tiruchi, then is it possible to measure in millimeters? It will take much time, correct or not? I will give you one small millimeter scale, or else I will give you one ruler. Our ruler I will give you. Is it possible to measure fastly?
No, sir.
No. So very difficult to measure with this scale. That is why. Depend upon our convenience. Our convenience, we have to use, understand, for calculating the different kind of lengths. Suppose if the bigger lengths are using measuring, then you can use kilometers. Smaller lengths are using, then you can use centimeters or millimeters. So depend upon our convenience, the type of units used depends on the magnitude of the length to be measured. That is what you have to remember. So how much length I am going to measure, either it is a looks very big or very small, or else it is very very small, depend upon it I have to use the different proper units of length to measure it. Depend upon the magnitude. Suppose, see, I will give you 1000 is the magnitude, 1000 kilometers. Which unit I have to use? 1000 is a kilometer. So which unit I need to use for measuring scale? Kilometer scale or meter scale or centimeter scale or millimeter scale? Which one? 1000. Magnitude is very bigger. Magnitude is bigger. So which scale I will use? Which scale I will use? Kilometer scale. Better or not? Suppose I will say magnitude is 0.1. So which scale I will use? 0.1. Which scale I will use? 0.1 means 1 by 10. So which scale I will use?
Millimeter.
Suppose I will say 50 centimeter. Which scale will you use?
Millimeter.
50 centimeter scale. Like that. Depend upon the magnitude. Depend upon the magnitude, we have to use the proper unit of length. That is what you should remember. Write it. The type of unit used. Sanat, are you writing? Use depends on the magnitude of the length. Use depends on the magnitude of the length. Magnitude of the length. Please write it, all of you. Magnitude of the length to be measured. To be measured, that is. Do you understand, all of you? Now, Neswara? Yes or no?
Sir.
Now, please discuss a few things regarding this one. So, what is the use of this? Suppose you take meter. Meter can be used. Suppose in our home, I will ask you to measure the dining table length. So which one you will use? Or else length of a room, or else height of a tree, or else height of a building. What kind of unit will you use? Or else measure the length of length and breadth of a school playground. Then which one will you use? Which unit will you use? Meter or centimeter?
Kilometer.
What?
Kilometer.
Huh? meter. Very good. Correct or not? Because our length, our room length is also, it will be like 10 meters or 20 meters. And the trees also, it won't be 1000 meters. So kilometers we cannot use, right? Because you take buildings and all, they won't be like a more than 500 meters or everything. Even 100 meters also won't be there. So to measure the length of buildings, a school playground, we can use it. Understand? So both measure meters and kilometers. So if you take anything like measuring the length of a dining table, length of a room, or height of a tree, or else measurement or length of your car or something, we can use meter scale. Because also we can use for measuring the width and breadth of a school playground, everything we can use meter scale, because it is a big unit of length which is suitable for measuring all the lengths. Suppose I will ask you measure a length of your pencil. You have a pencil, correct? Or else your notebook. So, or else I will say eraser. Which unit will you use, Ra? Eraser, pencil and all. Which unit will you use? Survey, see properly.
Centimeter.
Correct or not? Because our pencil won't be more than 30 centimeters. Correct or not? So, I will use our scale to measure this one. So, this writing pen is 13 centimeters. 13 centimeters is my writing pen. Like that, what will happen? So we can use water. We can suppose you want to measure the notebook. If you want to measure the pencil, then it is a small length. So which is much smaller than a meter. So it is convenient to express such a small length in terms of meters. So that is why the length of small objects is measured in which unit, Ranarayan? Sanat? Which unit? Centimeter. Small objects. So like that, it will go. Suppose I will ask you to measure the thickness of coin. Suppose let me take, I'm having a coin. Observe very carefully. This one, how you can measure? I'm having a one coin. All of you check it. I will ask you to measure the thickness of the coin. How you can measure?
Millimeter.
Huh? I will ask you to measure what is the thickness of this coin.
Millimeter.
Huh?
Millimeter.
That is what you have to remember it. So here you can see, like suppose I will ask you to measure the thickness of your paper, your notebook. So they are very, very smaller. So much smaller. So the thickness of coin or thickness of a wire, electric wire or something, they are very, very small length. So which is much smaller than even a centimeter. So it is very convenient to express very small lengths in terms of what? In terms of millimeters. In terms of millimeters. So small length is used to express in still smaller units called as millimeters. Like that, if you go, suppose I want to measure, suppose Narayan home to my home, I want to measure the distance. So which one I will use? Which scale I will use? I want to measure the distance from here to Narayan's home to my home, or else Sanat's home to my home. Which one? This is more distance. So which scale I will use, Sarvesh? Suppose the Sarvesh home and my home, it is very near, just opposite to us. So we can use meters also, no problem. But Narayan home is a little bit far from me. So that I have to use like a village to village, town to town, city to city, if we are measuring distance. Where do you use water, Sanat? Santosh? Kilometer. That is what you have to remember. So the distance between two villages or two cities and some etc. very big. That is why it is very convenient, understanding, to express in the case of kilometer. Because if you are trying to express in meters, it is even inconvenient to express. Suppose you see, what is the distance between Pudukkottai and Tiruchira? What is the distance between Pudukkottai and Tiruchi? I think around 52 kilometers. Correct or not? Yes or no? Sollunga pa. Yeah, 52. So 52 kilometers.
Yes, sir.
So actually, from Tiruchi to Pudukkottai, if you take a PDKT, understanding, Pudukkottai to TPY, if you take, it is around 52 kilometers. So is it possible? Which one is easy to measure? 52,000 meters or 52 kilometers? Which one is easy to you measure? This is
kilometers.
This is very big one. This is, suppose, Sarvesh will come and will ask you, Babu, please tell me what is the distance between Pudukkottai and Tiruchi. If you'll say 52,000 meters, or else 520,000 centimeters, or else 5 crore 20,000 understanding 5 crore 2 lakh millimeters, then how you people will scare or not? You will definitely will not understand anything. But if I'll say just 52 kilometers, then 52 kilometers only. But same thing if I'll express in centimeters, millimeters, then you imagine how much it is. Very, very big value. Is it yes or no? Because 52,000 meters, and again you can multiply with 100, two more zeros will increase. If it is a millimeter, three more zeros will increase. So this much big values will come. Then by the time, very difficult to express, and it is very inconvenient also, even expressing in meters. So that is why larger distances always we use. What will use, Ra? Which will use for larger distances?
Kilometers.
So the large distances are measured in a big called as kilometer. So please, all of you, note down this 4 point. Write it. The type of units used depends on the magnitude of the length to be measured. Correct or not? The first point. So right. Meter. Meter for what kind of purpose we can use, Ra? Meter is a quite big. Understand? Big to measure. To measure length. So we can use like measuring length of a room. We can use like measuring length of a room, height of a tree, etc. That is next. Second one, what? Meter over. Next, centimeter. Centimeter, what we can use for? Centimeter for what? The length of the small objects. Small objects is measured in centimeters. Remember, right? The length of a small objects is measured in centimeter. Next one. Third one. What is the third one, Raf? Third one. Even very, very small lengths. Expressed in what? Still smaller units called as millimeters. Remember? The very small lengths is, Santosh, are you understanding, Santosh? Expressed in smaller,
yes, sir.
Smaller unit called as, what is it called as? Millimeter. That is what. Next. To measure quite bigger lengths, last one, the distances to measure in a big unit, the large distances are measured in a bigger unit of length called as what, Ra? Called as what?
Kilometer,
which is represented with what? Km. That is what you have to remember. Millimeter, what is the representation, Ra? Mm. Next, centimeter, Ra? Cm. Next, meter, Ra? Meter. Yeah, smaller. That is what you have to remember. Please note it down. So this is all about why we should have the use of proper units of length. Where we have to use perfect unit. Depend upon the situation, we have to use the either centimeters or meters or kilometers or millimeters. Depend upon it. Suppose if I want to measure centimeters, means smaller distance, if I'm measuring with the kilometers, means a kilometer scale, then it is very difficult to hectic work to convert it and all. That is why, depend upon the situation, we have to use the right scale to measure the distances. Do you understand, all of you? Yes or no? Correct or not? That is what.
Yes, sir.
First one. The length. Yes, sir. Yeah, next one. We are going to study what? Length measuring devices. What is the device? Sir, how I can measure this length? That is what my question. So please, all of you keep writing. Already you know that one device. What is that? How we can measure the length? By using meter scale. Correct or not? Yes, sir. Yes, length measuring devices. Please keep writing. Length measuring devices. Length measuring devices. Please keep writing. Length measuring devices. And tell me what is that? So we have a various types of devices which are commonly used for measuring lengths. Correct or not? So everywhere, if you go to America, if you go to here, there and all, everywhere, they used to use two kinds of devices, commonly used devices for measuring a length. What is that? Can you able to say? One, basically you can see in our tailor shops and all are with you also. That is called as meter scale. Or else we can say that rulers, any rulers, not only meter scale, small scale or anything. And also one thing with tape, carpenters or else constructor, those who are constructing this mansions that all the constructing buildings there they will use. What is that? Can you able to say? That is something like a rolling. That meter tape. Understanding RLS measuring tape. Remember. So the length measuring devices are commonly used devices. Common devices which we are using. Devices which we are using is two types. One is what? Meter scale. What is that? Meter scale, or else we can call it as rulers. Scale is called as rulers according to the mathematics. Meter scale and meter tape. What is it called? Meter tape. This is only used to call it as measuring tape. Measuring tape. Have you seen measuring tape? Sanat, Lohit, Narayan, Sarvesh, Santosh. So they used to rotate. Can you able to see that?
Yes, sir.
Yes, so that is what. So
yes, sir.
Meter scale, yes, sir. You'll observe here. Meter scale is looks like a water.
Yes, sir.
This meter scale is looks like a what now, Nishran? It is looks like a rod. Correct or not? So it may be a metal or maybe a wood. It is made up of a wood or maybe a metal rod. So carrying from place to place, it is very difficult. That is why we can use, because it is not flexible material. If you try to break it, it will. If you try to bend it, it will break. Because this meter scales, I'm saying not this one, basically the meter scales is made up of metal, or it will, understand, it may be made up of wood. So this cannot be bent. They are not the flexible material which can bend easily around the object to measure the length. So that is why we should use a proper devices for measuring the lengths of an object. So the device to be used for measuring length depends on the type of the object, whatever the object. If it is a straight object or circle object, means a sphere objects or some curved objects, depend upon the type of the objects where we need to measure, and we need some different kind of objects. So let us go for the first one. Is object is straight. If the object is straight, what kind of one will use? This meter scale. If the object is straight, what we can use? Which scale will use? Meter scale. Understand? If the objects are straight, straight, if the objects are straight, we will use this scale. Do you understand now, Nishwaran? So if the objects are straight, we can use, understand, not only the meter scale, we can use measuring tape also, no problem. But meter scale means it won't be bent, we can easily measure. Suppose if you want to measure the table length of a table, it can be measured by using meter scale or measuring tape both. Or else a cloth merchant uses a meter rod. You may notice it. If you'll go and purchase 2 meters cloth, that fellow, he will measure like this meter rod and he will cut it there. Have you noticed it?